do things with my family, and I try to ask them for support. So we're gonna sing one song, and then I'm waiting for the rest of my family to come, and we'll sing another song. Okay, we're saving our family song till the rest of the family comes here, but we're gonna sing, "I Am a Child of God." Sorry, come back. The boss said, come back. You know, my nephew, he loves music. And I came here, I expected music all the way, like a music festival, because he just... Every time he comes to La Ye, first thing he does is he wants to sing. Auntie, let's sing. So we're going to sing our family song. Come on, Marin. I would like to invite my sister and my nieces and nephews to share their testimony of their cousin Bayne. Bayne, I love you. I'm going to miss you.
Hello for everyone. Oh, come on. You're not sleeping, yeah? Talofa, everyone. Talofa. Thank you. My name is Patricia. I'm Willie's middle sister. I'm the middle sister. I'm married. I have 5 children and 19 grandchildren. Bayne grew up with us. We all live at my dad's house. With our children, and of course my brother and his children, all our families were living together in one house. We all knew that Willie Boy was a singer, but when we heard this guy sing, it was totally different. Bayne has one of the sweetest high-pitched voice I ever heard. This guy can sing. He can change the rhythm to the songs. Sophia and my brother Willie, for me, I envy them. I envy his kids because our family, we're the Ngalea'is and the Tawil'ilis. My mom's family, they're very talented. They're musicians, they're dancers. I mean, you name it, they got it. But my mom, my sisters, our siblings, we're not very talented. We love to sing, don't get me wrong. When we get together as families and we do our family home evenings like we do, we sing a lot. I mean, and that's why we're so happy, because we love to sing. And every time this guy has a concert or my nephew, Willie Boy, has a concert, I mean, you talk about girls wishing and yelling and, yay, we're going to go. We're worse. I tell you, we're worse. We're calling each other and saying, okay, Willie Boy's going to go here. Come on, get ready. We'll come and pick you up. Okay? I mean, it's like, what do you call that? Lightning? A lightning bolt? Like when they say, Willie Boy is here or Bayne is performing here. It's like a shock to our body. You know, me and my sisters, we just love being with them. I had an experience with my nephew, Willie Boy. And this is way before I knew that this guy can really sing. I'm a person who loves to go to concerts, me and my other sister that's younger than me. And Willie Boy performed at Turtle Bay. And I was just so happy when they told me, hey, your nephew is over there. I said, I'm gone. I'm being there. So I walked in, and I guess his manager or the main singer was at the door, and I asked him, hey, is Willie Boy in there? He goes, yeah, but he's getting ready. I goes, could you tell him that his auntie's out here? He goes, oh, no worry, I'll tell him. Well, he couldn't come out because he was getting prepared to go on stage. But to my surprise, he went on stage, and he says, I want to dedicate a song to my auntie. It was me and my sister right here. We went to the concert. I dragged her with me. And he dedicated a song to me for my birthday. Mind you, it wasn't even my birthday. You know, but I was so proud. I was so proud of him. And, you know, I am proud of all my nieces and nephews. In fact, I'm proud of all my family. I'm so glad to be a Ngalea'i and a Tawili'ili. But, you know, just to let you guys know, I can sing too. But, you know, I don't show my talent because, you know, I'm not very that good of a singer. But, you know, Bayne, I want you to know that you're always in our hearts. You'll always be in our hearts no matter where you are, no matter where we are. Know that we love you. Know that we'll take care of your brothers and your sister and, of course, your parents. We love you from the bottom of our heart. You know, go and prepare a way for us that we may be able to see you again. We love you, and I say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
I don't know what she said about talented, but I know I am. I'm a great dancer. I mean, I may not be able to sing, but I can dance. So I'm Willie's younger sister. I'm right after him. We've lived together a couple times when growing up. He lived with me. And his kids always came visit. I think I'm closer to them than anybody else. By the way, let me introduce myself. My name is Lonnie. Born and raised in La'ie. Have my family in La'ie, still in La'ie. One thing I know about Bayne is that he got from my side of the family is he's loud. We come from a loud family, you know, and every time Bayne was around, I knew he was there. Because he was loud. He made himself noticed to our family. He sang loud so that we would turn around and just listen to him.
wanted to let Bayne know that I love him too. And that I wouldn't be anywhere else but here to say my last goodbyes to him. What he's taught me is that never overlook how they are. Always try to know more about them. Always be in the knowing. He taught me that because I want to know what's going on with my kids. I just wish he was loud for me. I just wanted to be there for him. I love each and every one of you, especially my brother Willie and my sister Sophia and her kids. I think I always knew them from growing up. It was always my house that we always went party at, but we don't party anymore. We just have a good time partying, eating, and of course dancing, because I'll just stand up and dance. But I'm so grateful to be here with Bayne too. Oh, and I didn't know Bayne was a Uipa. Uipa is my dad's name. I always thought it was just Bayne Tinei. But I'm so grateful that he's named after my father, because I'm named after my father too. That just brings me more closer to him than ever. Bayne, please watch over us. I love you. And I say this to you in Jesus Christ, amen.
Brothers and sisters, family and friends, aloha. My name is Lila, and my mother is the eldest of the Tau'ili'ili family. She's the older sister of my Uncle Willie. And I am just so grateful to be here, to be amongst people who share the common love of this beautiful spirit. We're here to celebrate such a vivacious person who enjoyed life, who loved his family, who loved music, and could touch the lives of so many people just by being around them. Bayne grew up in my grandma's house in his earlier years. I remember dropping my oldest daughter off, and Grandma Loimaka would babysit them every morning and feed them supoesi, something that I never liked eating. But I just remember him, because I feel he pulls a lot on the Tau'ili'ili side, his looks, his demeanor, his spirit, and I'm just so grateful for that. We had an experience this past May. I was in charge of the Kahuku High School Project grad, and we had organized the bands to come and play for us, which was Rebel Soldiers and Johnny Sweet and his gang, and we were just so thrilled. The kids had no idea who was going to show up to perform until that evening. So I remember sitting at the back of the venue, and I was just busy eating. I knew it was going to be a long night, so I could hear the band from the back, and my son, who graduated, ran to the back, and he's like, "Mom, Bayne is singing." I was like, "No, son, you got it wrong. Willie Boy is coming out." He goes, "No, Mom, Bayne's singing," and I couldn't see a thing from the back. And I just remember Bayne being on stage and pointing out to him and says, "You easy," you know, and it just made my son feel like $1 million. I remember one time we had a Sunday gathering at my grandpa's house, which we did often. It was a family tradition we looked forward to. Every month we'd get together for family eating at Big Mama's house. And we continue to do it today. And I remember one day calling Bayne and letting him know, "Hey, we're having konga'i this Sunday. If you can make it, that'll be great." He goes, "Oh, Auntie, I work." And I says, "Okay, well, next month we'll see you." He goes, "You can count on that." A few hours later, he shows up with guitar in hand. He had walked from the bus stop, and I asked him. I hadn't known how he had gotten there. And I says, "How did you come?" He goes, "Auntie, I came straight from work. because I didn't want to miss out on this. Family was important to Bayne. Everything he did revolved around that, whether it was his parents, his siblings, or his music family. He did anything and everything for them. One thing I won't ever forget about him is the way he made me feel. The way he made others feel. That although you don't see him in person, you can feel of his love, even through social media, through text messages, or just being in the audience and watching him on the stand, doing what he loved best. I want to thank his music, Ohana. For allowing him to share what he loved on the stage. For being such an important part of bringing out the best in my cousin. For allowing him to shine his light, to reach those through social media, through concerts, through events, through the radio. Thank you for allowing him to magnitude his talent so that we could enjoy it today. Thank you, thank you. I have a true love of the gospel that I belong to. I know this is not the end. The great joy in being here and celebrating Bayne's life is knowing that this separation is only temporary, that we will see him again, that he is rejoicing with families who are beyond the veil. I think of his grandparents and his uncles and aunties who have greeted him with open arms as he joins them today. I love my family with all of my heart. I would do anything for them. And I love each and every one of you for being a part of Bayne's life and for allowing him to share the best of him with all of you. These things I humbly say in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Hello, everybody. My name is Hannah. This is Elijah. We did music with Bayne. But not just music, but we did life together. Music, life. So many memories with Bayne. I was just telling Elijah in the back. I'll share this one memory of him a couple weeks before he passed. Elijah texts me and he's like, hey. Tonight's gig, we're gonna wear jerseys. I was like, okay, shoot. So I text Bayne, hey, did you get the message? He's like, yeah. And then he ghosted me for like 2 hours. And when he does that, it's kind of scary because he tends to fall asleep and not show up to gigs. And so I call him up and I'm like, Bayne, did you get the message? He's like, yeah. He's like, jerseys. Yeah, so like, okay. I was like, what you wear, black pants? He's like, yeah. And I was like, okay. What time you gonna be there? Sully. I was like, Bayne! And he's like, oh. Like, how you gonna talk to me for like 20 seconds and then fall asleep? So I call up Elijah, right? You won't believe what just happened. I call Bayne and he was talking to me and he fell asleep. And then I was like, hey, you better call him now. Get him to the gigs before he don't show up. Because he's done that a few times. But that's like one of my favorite memories of Bayne before he passed. But there's so much memories, bro. Like, I grew up with Bayne. I grew up with the family. And like, Ani Ani Pupole, it's like our family. We did music. We did sports. We were so poor. We never had We never had money for instruments. And if we did have a ukulele, it was missing a couple strings. So we would walk around, with Pahu, just looking for like hallways or like an echo stairwell. Somewhere that had like nice reverb and we just harmonize. And like, and that was like our drug, you know, we feed for the harmony. And Bayne was loud, like, but it was so awesome to watch him grow and sing, because I told him, man, I love watching you sing, because you improve so much instead of just being loud now, like he's good, you know, like he was super good, like, if you knew how he sang before, it was just loud, like, he could hit the note, but it was so loud, like, my man never knew how to blend, like, we all had to, like, oh, Bayne, can you stand over there? And then we went, like, he don't need a mic. Now he's like, man, he grew so much into his voice and he got so much better. And, you know, like, I was telling Eliza, man, like, it's so hard because, it's like, it's my brother. We're gonna miss him, for sure.
What's up, everybody? My name is Elijah, and I had the honor and privilege of sharing the stage with Bayne for the last 6 years. I met Bayne in 2016. It was December 31st. It was New Year's Eve, I was at a gig watching my cousin then play, and I seen Bayne, just this tall, handsome looking, light skinned Uso, coming with his fedora. And he's like, hey, you Clandon's cousin, yeah? I was like, yeah. And then after that, we ended up staying in contact even after I left for college. I moved home mid-2016, and I wanted to pursue a music career. And so while I was going out to the clubs, just to network, I wasn't partying or anything, but I was looking and I seen Bayne on stage, and everyone's right, he was loud. And I was like, bro, I need another big guy with that type of energy behind me. And Bayne has been with me ever since. And there are a few L's that I feel represent Bayne very well. He's loving, he's loyal, and he's always late. And no matter how many times he was late or slept through a gig, there's just an essence about him. He has a joyful presence so strong that I could never fire him. Or I fire him and rehire him 3 days later. Bayne has the record of how many times I fire somebody and then rehire them. It was, sometimes you show up in his work uniform and how can you get mad at that? That just shows how passionate he was about music and the grind and his loyalty to me and all of our other brothers and sisters that he was extremely loyal to in this industry. And, the other thing is, music is one thing, you know, and we shared that passion with one another. But to do life with him was another thing. And I had the opportunity to walk with him over the last few years and minister to him. And I remember one time, the many car rides I've had with Bayne, and he was just sharing with me that he was going through a hard time. And I had the opportunity to share this worship song with him, and the song is called Graves into Gardens. And in the beginning of the song, it says, I've searched the world, but it couldn't fill me. A man's empty praise and treasures that fade are never enough. And if you listen to those words, it just talks about where your strength comes from. You can search the world, you can search in the bar, you can search anywhere else in the world for joy and for strength, but it's only temporary. But when you find the strength in Jesus Christ, that is something that will forever empower you and give you the strength to endure. And that's something I had the honor of sharing with Bayne. And I want to share that. It would be a disservice for me to stand up here and not share that with all the Polynesians in the house tonight, today. And I know a lot of us grew up in Polynesian households. And as men, we were raised to stay strong, don't show any fear, Don't show any pain, don't cry. But I just want to go against the grain and tell all of my usos in the house, it's okay to let your emotions show. It's okay to talk about it with your usos. It's extremely important that at such a time like this, when we're struggling, we're in pain, that we find a community of brothers to hold each other accountable, to sharpen one another, and to pour out and pour back in. It is extremely hard to stand up on a stage and pour out constantly without your cup being full. And so it's important. I promise you, all my usos in the house, you don't lose no gangster when you cry. I promise. You won't lose no gangster points when you call your uso and you need someone to pray for you. When you call your uso and you need someone to talk to. When you call your uso and you need someone to offload all your problems. Any family of beings is my family. So if you ever need somebody to just pray over you, even if we haven't even met today, but you heard this message, even through the people online, call me. My phone is on 24 hours a day, and I'm more than willing to stand in the gap for you and pray and contend for healing and contend for God to pour his blessings into your life. It's important that you understand this life is not meant to be walked through alone. We are here to walk with one another, and it's important that we do that so that we continue to walk forward in the path that God has ordained for our life. Amen? Amen. Love you guys. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to have a public visitation, a viewing up until about 12:30, the beginning of the services. At the conclusion of the services, we'd like the visitation strictly to be for Bayne's immediate family. So please, we want you to make sure that you have the opportunity to pay your respects. We don't want to have to rush anybody in doing so. Also, once again, there's refreshments outside on the lanai area. Help yourselves, and please, if you have more memories to share, that's why we do this, right? We do this because Bayne is important, and he'll always be important. We gather here this morning not because he died. We gather here because he lived, and all of you loved him, and we loved him, and he loved you. That's what makes today special. Doesn't mean that our hearts aren't heavy, that we're not filled with sadness. We are. But we pull together as a family, as a community, to help one another to get through these difficult times, and we keep on loving one another. Because that's what we're supposed to do. So once again, on behalf of the entire family, they do wish to express their appreciation to all of you for being here. Mahalo.
Good morning, everybody. As my family visiting and everybody else visiting, I just wanted to introduce myself. My name is Eleni Lilo. I'm from the Lilo family. Sophia's grandma, my grandma's sisters. That's out of relations. I've known Bayne, you know, we haven't been in contact with his mom, but I've known him since he was a little kid. And the only time we would bump into each other is when we have family gathering. And it's sad to say that this is the only time that we get to see families at the funeral. At least most of the family. But I want to take this opportunity and to express my gratitude for Sophia and her kids with everything that they have done throughout the years. We hardly see each other, but this is the only time that we get to see each other. That being said, as parents, for me, speaking for myself, I think to spend more time with our children and families, sometimes, you know, we take things for granted. And thank you.
Since I met you, can't forget you. Whoa, am I? Thank you. Please welcome our world.
just want to know your name. Can you just let me through so we can be together? So we can be together. La di da di da. They want to die, they look into your eyes. They're sweet, they said to go up, but they make them want to know. See you standing there, they want to make you shake. Woo! Cause girl, I see you standing there. I just want to know your name. And you just let me know where we can be.
Can I say something?
Thank you.
Hey, hey, hey. Brothers and sisters, Talofa. For those who may not know me, my name is Vic. And I was part of Bayne's music family. I'm terrible at speeches, but I don't know if anybody had to fly over here, but I think I traveled the farthest. I came from Utah, so I forgot how sweat is. Like, I forgot how for sweat, so. But anyways, I just want to, I don't have a lot of good memories with Bayne, because all of them are kind of not for the church, yeah? So what I will say is, I love Bayne very much. I love them as a brother. I was the oldest of four, so I always felt like Bayne was an older brother than me, even though I was kind of bigger. But I know if Bayne was sitting up in this room. He doesn't like awkwardness, huh? So the awkward silence is kind of like his thing. He knows how to make awkward moments not awkward anymore. So when I say, yee yee, you guys say, yee yee, all right? 1, 2, 3, yee yee! All right, that's a story I could tell. So that if you heard that in Waipahu, that's probably us crackhead wannabe singers, huh? Was always calling out for Bayne or for Hana. I'm sure Auntie was tired of that noise, huh? Like, oh, they in the front door, or they trying to take my son away from me again. But anyways, before I sit down, I wanna call the original Mama Boys. That was we grew up together. And a little bit of help, because the Mama's Boys don't sound the same anymore. So Kale, Hana, Jake, if you want to come up, brother, we can make this awkward silence not awkward anymore by singing a couple songs. Please. And out of the four Mama's Boys, I was the best rapper in the group. But I never rap. I never like showed him. This was before Drake too, so. Hey, sound guy, can we go up here? Okay. Yeah, thank you. Hey, you guys can take it. And again, Bayne hates the quietness, yeah? So that's why I was sitting back there. I was like, Bayne must be mad at us right now. He must be like, bro, you guys, why are you guys so quiet? So that's, I'm not going to sing, but they're going to sing. But yeah, just for you, brother. I know yeah. And man, I left Hawaii like 2012. So I kind of whitewashed, yeah? And we was chilling last night, going over our song. And this beautiful voice right there, Kale. He's part of the Ekolu, but I don't like Braga. Kale and Hana them, they sang this beautiful Hawaiian song. And I know if Bayne, if you can hear me, brother, I know you stay. Niho, if you hear too, brother, please. I know Bayne is gonna smile. Because of this one, and I hope you guys do too. They let me keep talking. Yeah. Again, this is the original Mama's Boys right here. I hold the Mama's Boys dear to my heart. It's what made me grow a passion for music. Yeah. The last time I seen Bayne was 2016, when I came for my sister's wedding, and I'm not popular, but. Everybody wanted to hang out with me for some reason. But I told them, I just gotta go see my mama's boys. And I always make it a priority for see them. Hopefully we don't sound rusty, but is the mic on? We go jam. Round of applause, please. Yeah!
Thank you.
That was beautiful, right? Yeah, I think I'm Hawaiian too. But man, Bayne, I love you, brother. And I always will, man. I didn't want to cry because I don't have any bad memories of Bayne. But Val, Bayne's parents, brothers and sisters, I will always and forever love you guys. Because you guys blessed our lives and a lot of other lives with Bayne. I'm pretty sure he's telling me to shut up and stop crying and keep singing, yeah? But again, I'm not going to sing. I'm not going to sing yet. I'm going to have the boys is setting up something over here.
Oh, we done.
Okay.
We're going to go with the schedule program.
Okay, we're going to go with the schedule program. But again, brother, I'll see you again. I'm pretty sure of that. And I love you. Thank you.
Morning. My name is Bert. Just a couple memories of Bayne and his brothers. I used to have this studio at the Waipo Intermediate, and his brother them used to always come to the studio, make beats, play some music, and yeah, it was pretty awesome just to see him. He's a good kid, and you know, always following Lauren. I also have another memory because we used to always play video games, but it wasn't our video game. It was an Xbox, but we used to always borrow it from Lauren and Bayne. And one time, the thing just overheated, and I was like, oh, man, I think we broke it. And they came over the house. I was like, how come you guys not playing games? It's like, oh, I think it's overheated. I think it's broken. It's like, oh, just throw them in the freezer. And we was all tripping like, this guy's serious, Lord. Throw them in the freezer on Xbox now. You know what I mean? So it's like, I guess, you know what I mean? So we threw it in the freezer. 10 minutes later, it cooled down. It ended up working. So I was tripping. I was like, was this like a thing? You know what I mean? Like, I was like, it's not my power thing. Cause, you know what I mean? The thing broke it, throw them away. You know what I mean? Just get the regular Super Nintendo. You know what I mean? But yeah, it was just good memories with him. And the family was pretty awesome. You know, it was pretty close growing up in Uipa. But yeah, like I said, he used to always follow Lauren. And Jordan used to come along a little bit, you know, but yeah, it was pretty awesome just to, you know, be a part of that family. But I love you guys. I just know he's in a better place watching over us.
Sorry, I'm not as tall as my brother. Sorry. How's it? My name is Khalil Perkins. I kind of have a feeling that kind of feel like me and Bayne are kind of alike because, like, I still waiting for him to jump out and be like, Sully, I'm right here. You know, like, I'm right here, like he always does, but when I got the news, it was heartbroken. He was so young. I still remember waking up every day for high school, picking him up at the Blue House in Pupuole. He was always late, but for me, it was like more time to spend with him. I was like, bro, what are we gonna do? Ah, let's just go to school and after we just do whatever. We had our ups, we had our downs. We had our crew in high school. And our stairs was right by E building. He would always go into the bathroom and just sing. Told me he was gonna be great. And he is. I love you, my soul family. And bro, I know you're looking down at me. I know you're gonna slap me in your face because you don't let me cry. But that's me, bro. I got you. I'm gonna see you one day. Thank you, guys.
Special love we must secure. in my heart. There's no better feeling than when I rise up to see the morning sun and watch the sunrise in your eyes. You're like the summer breeze that comes to me in the winter time. So baby, take this love of mine. Anything you want, girl, I will give it to you. Anything you need, girl, my heart will always be true. Anything you want, girl, I'll be sure to give it to you. Anything you need, girl, my heart will always be true. Your bit, you're twice as shy. I have no reason to ask why. Why, oh, why? So we must understand the ultimate plan. And now we live a happy life in a body of mind. Yeah, yeah. There's no better feeling than when I rise up to see the morning sun and watch the sunrise in your eyes. Eyes, baby, you're like the summer breeze that comes to me in the winter time. Baby, I hope you realize.
How's it, everybody? My name is Billy, and I'm gonna try to get through this without the ugly cry. But I met Bayne through my brother Lowe over there. We were in Oasis, fellowshipping, hanging out, and Bayne got dropped off from some of his friends, and he was chilling, and. It's real, when I met him, I was like, wow, he's pretty light-skinned compared to Lo. And I was like, wow, he's, but, you know, they get the matching long hair, and I was like, you know, he was real cool. But I didn't get close to Bayne until we actually worked together at Regal Theater. He was the guy in the front, the podium, to take the tickets. So, you know, he would always be singing, no doubt, that's him. Music was his life, so he would sing loud in the front. And then we had our walkie-talkies, and I would be in the back sweeping. And he would be like, he'd be singing so loud, I could hear in the radio the managers trying to say, hey, Bayne, you're too loud, Bayne, you gotta keep it down. But I could still hear him from the back sweeping. Singing loud, and finally they told me and my uncle that was working with him. We were like, "Can you guys go tell Bayne to keep it down?" So we walk up to Bayne in the front, still singing, and he goes, "I tell him, sorry, Bayne, the manager's singing too loud," and I noticed he didn't have the earpiece. And he's like, I don't care. What they gonna do, fire me? I was like, I don't know, but you know, he just never stopped singing, you know, whether we were sweeping, taking out trash. You know, I would try singing with him, but I couldn't keep up. Like, he was so, like, he just, you know, it was always a good time with him. And it was hard when I heard the news, because I met him when he was in high school, and you know, I call him my kid brother because I just watched him grow up all these years. You know, I saw the good times, you know, the bad times. You know, we'd always play Xbox together, and it's just hard not to get that party invite anymore. he'd always invite me even though I wasn't even home. And he was always hard on himself, you know. Like always, everything he did. And I told him, why you gotta be so hard? So you know, the world's hard enough. You don't have to be hard on yourself all the time. He used to apologize every time he died in war zone. I said, so you don't need to apologize. Next round we get him. But, you know, just, I miss him so much. And I love you guys. You know, and just, I don't know, this is hard. But I just wanted to share a little bit about him that, I don't know, sorry. Thank you guys.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, we're going to begin the services in about a half an hour. We'd like to make sure everybody has the time to say their goodbyes to Bayne. At the conclusion of the services, we will only have viewing for his immediate family. At the conclusion of the services, the family has bentos for everybody, just to kind of let everybody know about the pandemic and how it affects institutions like the church and even the mortuary. They don't allow the consumption of those bentos on property. If they do, then we fall into different category and it's just more chaotic. But please make sure that you get the bentos before you go home, but we ask that it not be consumed here on property. Once again, we have about a half hour more for visitation. Please, if you'd like to, do so.
Thank you. Ain't got no time to go.
Good morning, everybody. I just want to introduce myself. My name is Joseph Mao. I graduated with Bayne in Waipao High School. And to be honest, I haven't really been with him the past like couple of years, but I just wanted to share a sweet memory of my brother Bayne. I went to August Aaron's Elementary, and then I think Bayne was in Waipao Elementary. So growing up, I was so out of place in August Aaron's. And then when I came to Waipao Intermediate, Bayne was the first guy to reach out to me. And he was such a good friend. We had a little singing group. One of the pictures you see now, his other friend, Wayne. I don't think Wayne came today. I think he's still in the mainland, but we had a little singing group. Savannah. we had a little singing group. It wasn't special or anything. I think it was just like hey you loner, come over here and sing with us. So that's why Bayne brought me in, and I was so happy to be a part of this group. It was me, Bayne, Wayne To'o, and Christian Palaita. And we used to sing by those bleachers. I don't know if any of you guys went to Waipao Intermediate, but there's those bleachers, and then that place where we do that electric slide to that slow little song that Mrs. Adric used to teach us. But yeah, we used to sing around those bleachers, and at that time, they could sing. All I could do was just stand there and small kind harmonize with them. And this one time, we sang that song that I heard it on Vic's Facebook Live last night. They sang Silhouette, and then I was singing with them, and after being wait, Joe, you gotta do it like this. And then ooh, I was like, whoa, okay, sheesh, take my spot already. But yeah, that's just my memory from intermediate. As we went on to high school, we played football together. I can't tell you what position we played because we weren't on the field. That's why me and Bayne were always on the bench. But yeah, man, this guy was so funny, man. Everything about him. Even though we didn't start, man, we were the loudest ones on the sideline and stuff. But it's so hard to really know somebody until you go with them through like football training or like any kind of sport, because like that's when you see the real ugliness of them. Yeah, like when Coach Sean used to tell us, "Oh, everybody, roll all the way from the 100 or from that yard line all the way to the other side, the other end zone." And you get up, you look at their face, they're like all like this and stuff. And that's when you see your true character. I was still rolling on the 20-yard line. I didn't reach the end zone yet. Bayner's already done. He got up, even though all wobbly, walking up to me. "Come on, Joe, you can do it. That's how Bayne was. He was always there for our family and friends. And the last one, I think Bayne's going to hate me for this one. But, Rebel Soldiers, I don't know if this is true, but Bayne told me this song that you guys sang one time. Oh, you guys weren't, we were still in high school, but Rebel Soldiers wasn't that well known yet. But Bayne said, "Oh yeah, I wrote this song, but it's going out to my best friend." I go, "Who? You, Joe?" I go, "Why? You remember that girl we've been talking about? Yeah, I heard she likes you." And then I go, "What song is it?" He's like, "Oh, it starts off like this. What do you do when the girl that you're with isn't in love with you?" I was like, "You sure you wrote that song?" He's like, yeah, just listen. "And what do you do if your best friend is the one that she loves?" I was like, "No way, I don't believe you." Not that. But yeah, the truth was, she didn't love any of us. Well, man. It's just, it's coming to these times. There's a lot of funerals. I just came from another one not too long ago, but it's coming to realize like it's really hard living in this world. And bro, I'm so happy. I'm not happy that you're gone, but I'm happy that you're not suffering with what we have to go through. You don't have to wake up anymore and get ready for work and stuff. And I just pray that a family finds comfort. I lost my mom a couple years ago, and the one thing one of the pastors told us was, this is not the end of seeing your loved one. Right now is the time that we should all get ready to meet them at the end. And I just want to say I love you, Bayne. And one more story, because I'm pretty sure a lot of you, Bayne has a lot of friends on Instagram. So this last story, I think this is the last message Bayne sent me before right now. He told me, he sent me a video. I think you guys all know. He sent me a video. He's like, "Hey, you guys want to turn $300 into $3,000 cash?" So, Bayne, I'm kind of waiting for my money to come back. Nah, I didn't send him any money. But yeah, I wrote to Bayne, and then Bayne told me, "Oh, no, that was a hack. Somebody spammed me." But yeah, I just want to say, I love you, bro. Rest in peace. Say hi to our all our family up there. Man, the choir in heaven must be excited to get a star singer coming up. But yeah, just want to say I love you guys all. Thank you for this opportunity, and amen.
Amen. All I wanna know is can I get your mind, Lord? Beautiful she is. I never ever get to love like this. I've been wondering what a woman like you is doing all alone. So hey, what it say? Maybe we should get to talk there. Bright and up as well like it's a holiday. Come on, pretty girl, what are you say? So couple do so try to stick a couple lies. Just so they play a couple tricks up on your mind. But I'm too when it comes to the realness. Give me a love and I'll show you the business. Take my hand and understand. Maybe I could be a better man. Maybe we should take some time away. Brighten up this world like it's a holiday. Home on pretty girl, what do you say? She knows she got me when she come around, she come around. When she come around, when she come around. The way you do me, love me body. You drive me crazy. You are my lady, laughing, silly. Thinking of daisies. The guy that tell me, tell me what you gonna do right real now. Cause I'm too that's good. Just me and you. Just me, yeah, 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 yeah. The gentleman, baby, we should take some time away.
Hey, baby, we can talk, yeah. Why did I just feel like
Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to begin the services in about 10 minutes. Bayne's mom would like all of you to have the opportunity to say whatever you would like to say to Bayne. So if you'd like to come forward one last time, this is your opportunity, because once again, at the conclusion of the services, we'll only have visitation for her, for Bayne's family. Thank you.
I want you to drop, baby, drop, baby, drop. Why don't you drop all your love on me? Drop, baby, drop, baby, drop. Drop, 'cause I'm hungry.
Sorry, everybody. Telling a story how I met this guy, bro. This guy's a lovable guy, man. I met him when they moved to Uipa. I seen him at school already, but I never talked to him. I seen him taking his trash one day, I was walking in my backyard. So, hey, you from school? Yeah, yeah, my name's Bayne. My name's Nick, bro. Back then, they had the fence between our buildings. So, he talking like this. But after that, couldn't even, right there, couldn't even keep us apart, bro. Oh, up. Okay, sorry about it. But man, so I get plenty of memories. That's the first one time I met him. The last time I seen him was at a gathering at their house. And I got him at their house, my man was, I walk up with my case and he's like, hey, my best friend Nick right there, everybody. I was like, oh, you gotta do that, man. But I'm gonna miss that every time, bro. Oh, I love you, bro. Wish you was with us still yet. I love you and I see you when I see you, bro. Rest easy, man, also.
Good afternoon, family. First of all, I'd like to thank everybody for being here, attending the service. Mr. Reddy Noso. Don't mind me, I'm nervous. My name is Jake. Me and Nick is Bayne's best friend. I love this Uso. Those days I went away, 10 and a half years, I always been in touch or kept tabs on this Uso. Nothing but fond memories of him. Those days that I spent with him, for those of you who didn't know him, I wish you guys did know him. This individual was just electrifying on stage. He wouldn't play background, he would charge the stage. I'm so glad for all the memories that I had and I spent with them. I love you, Mouso. Rest in paradise. Thank you all.
Guy in that white hat's mom, Nick Barney. He was such a loyal friend to our son. They were like glued, together. We couldn't get them away. There's so many stories that I want to share with you, so many. But I think probably take the whole day. And I wanted to tell him that he was so loyal to our son. And we're gonna miss him. The last time we saw Bayne was when Nikki turned 30. in April, and he came over. So we had a party in the backyard, and we told him if he could sing a few songs, and he did. Mind you, we live in an apartment, so we were in the back of the lower floor. He was singing. Oh my God, I was so so proud of him and what he had accomplished in his life. So he was singing like 5 songs. Our neighbors upstairs were like, oh my gosh, we thought it was a radio. And Bayne was like, oh, thank you, thank you. There's this one story now that we met the dad's side, where Bayne and Nikki got in trouble. They went to Kahuku. Well, they were supposed to be in school, but they end up in Kahuku. The police called us, called my husband, and said, oh, you need to pick up your son. He's here in Kahuku. We don't know. You need to pick him up. So Nick went to pick them up, and we were trying to figure out why in Kahuku, out of all the schools they missed, they went all the way to Kahuku to cut class. So now I know, because his family was there, and it's a big family. Well, to cut it short, Nikki was getting lectured the same time Bayne was getting lectured to by Nick's dad. If anybody knows Nick's dad, they would be scared of him. A lot of his friends don't even want to come around because of Nick. But only Bayne, no matter what Nick tells him, he's still stuck there with my son getting lectured and everything. That's why he was like another son of ours. We have another son who also, all three of them, they got so close with Lala. Lala, you know, the trouble too, Lala. And I was shocked when we found out about Bayne, and I'm still in shock. Fia knows what they went through together as they were kids. And I love this kid so much. Because when Nick went away too, he always came to see me and the dad and check up on us and want to give us. That's how I know he's so loyal. He would come and bring money to put in Nick's books when Nick was away. And I would cry and say, oh my God, this kid is so. That's why I'm taking it hard that he's gone. But Bayne, your memories are always with us. And I love you. And thank you for being so good to this guy. And my wheel of my love, Bayne. Thank you.
Every day.
Ladies and gentlemen, of course, once again, we'd like to thank all of you for being here. Bayne's mom has asked me to announce one more time. Please, if you want to pay your final respects, to do so, because we're not going to let anybody else come forward other than the immediate family at the conclusion of the services. The reason being is that we have to be at Valley of the Temples on time. Burial at Valley of the Temples will take place at 3 o'clock. You folks are more than welcome to attend those services. At the conclusion of the services and the family paying their final respects, the funeral procession will proceed on to Valley of the Temples. If you are a part of that procession, we do have to obey all the traffic laws. So if, say, for example, I'm driving the hearse and we get the parents and a couple of other cars and they get through the light and it turns red, you have to stop. We suggest that you folks go ahead of us to Valley of the Temples, meet us there, and then we can, of course, all have the graveside services. At the conclusion of those services, the family invites you to their family residence at 94535 Avamoy Street in Waipahu, where they're going to have Kanikapila and the Valaau session. So please, if you have the time, continue to join the family to celebrate Bayne's life. Once again, before we start the services, this is a final opportunity for final viewing. Thank you.
Never had any cars or anything. Like I said, we was poor. So everywhere we went, we were skanking. We would skank everywhere. If we had to go to Village Park, we would walk to Village Park. But Bayne was so desperate today, that one day. And he ended up taking Will's car. And he was pulling out of the driveway. And it was like, oh, what are we doing? And he's like, come on, jump in. And so everybody was about to jump in. Will was just walking into Pupuale, and he seen his car pulling out. And then he was like, okay. We left Bayne. I was like, sorry. It was like cockroaches. We all would split. And then Bayne threw it in reverse. And I think he almost whacked the pillar of the building. And then we just seen Bayne get lickings. Like, I was like, Sole, I'm so sorry. I cannot even help you right now. But we all knew where to meet up after, and yeah, that's just a funny memory. I figure I showed you guys.
Good morning, everyone. Or good afternoon. I'm Sophia Sua, Bayne's mom. This is my husband, William Ely, Bayne's dad. This is never easy for a parent. It's been said many, many times before. You always think you're going to go before your child. But we want to express our love and appreciation for all of you coming out and celebrating our son's life with us. We know he was a beautiful spirit, and he always instilled happiness in everyone, even though he was going through hard times himself. I just want to encourage everyone, every parent, to always be open with your children. I was very open with my children. They could say anything in front of me. And sometimes my husband would look at me and go, they're really saying that to you? And I would say, yeah. Because I was very open with them. I didn't want them to hide anything from me. And I always expressed that, you know, that's the only way you're going to live and learn about things. And that's the only way I'm going to know what you guys are going through. And just be open with me. But to the parents, I just want to encourage you to always be open with your children. Always be encouraging to them. And always asking them about their day, how they're feeling. And especially showing them how much you love them. Always expressing how much you love them. I know parents do that naturally, but sometimes the child doesn't feel that. I'm not a very good speaker, but again, I just want to say thank you to everyone that's come out. Your presence and you guys, your love and your support helps us to be strong and move forward, knowing that our son was loved so much. And we thank you and appreciate all of you. We love you all so much. Thank you so much. We love you.
As we begin the services, if you're part of the ceremony and it's a call upon you, we're going to ask if you can make your way onto the stage and speak from this podium, either use the side entrance to the left or to the right. Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to thank all of you for being here once again to celebrate the life of Bayne. Losing a son, losing a brother, losing a friend, a nephew, is never easy. It's always probably one of life's most difficult moments. But it's today that makes this day special, because we gather together to support one another, to love one another, and we thank you for being here. To open up the services, if I can call upon Miley, she has a big task. She is going to lead us in the opening song, Yes, Jesus Loves Me. And the song is going to be a cappella, so if you know the words, we encourage all of you to please sing along. And after that, then I'll be calling upon Nick to open up in prayer. So, Nick, if you can make your way to the side entrance as well.
Aloha, everybody. If you guys don't mind singing this song with me, don't be shy. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Sing with me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Oh, yes, Jesus loves me. Oh, yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. For the Bible tells me so. Love you, Bayne. Thank you, guys.
Hello, everybody. It's Sorry, I'm nervous now. God is good. And all the time, hey, please bow your head. So, dear Heavenly Father, we are here today, here on this beautiful day to say our goodbyes to a brother, a friend, grandson, and much more. Are also being sworn. We ask for your blessings and protection over us as we send him on his way home into your arms. Father, I ask to please help us through dark times like this with your never-ending love and healing hands. Give those who need strength the strength to carry on. Oh, shit. We know it'll be hard to let go of being, but with our faith and belief in you, time will do its work. Thank you for blessing us with the chance of getting to know him. Heaven has gained another angel. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
If I can call upon Bayne's brother, William, he's going to come forward and eulogize his brother, as well as speak about this relationship that they shared together.
Aloha and talofa, family and friends. I'm the oldest brother of four. And I decided to take this eulogy for my brother, not because I'm the oldest, but because I know he would have done the same thing for me. I'm not an outspoken person like him, but surprisingly, I sing in front of thousands. So I'm going to make this short and sweet. Bayne, Uipa, Tinei, Sua. My brother, born on November 21, 1991, at Kuku Hospital, to our parents, William Ili and Sophia Sua. He was number three of us, four children. I chose to come up for this eulogy because I told you guys. I wanted to make it short, so this is what I wanted to do. Bad, good, and some of laughing moments that I had with him. So I'm going to start with the bad. There were so many. I'll tell you. But I'm just going to tell you one thing that I remember. I used to buy clothes, and sorry. So he was my size clothes, my size shoes, size everything, underwear, you name it. While I was in high school, while he was in high school, and I graduated already, and yes, I was still living with my mom. This guy's eyes was already big, sparking up all my clothes that I bought. I look at him, I told him, try. You try. You better not be wearing my clothes. And then what? Monday came, school day. I started getting ready. My clothes was missing. So I ended up waiting for him till he finished school. So, you know, Mama's boys and Bayne, they always had this animal collar, whatever you call it. So yeah, they never had phones, and that was the only way they could get each other. And you can hear them all the way down the street. You just hear them, yee. And then you just hear Bayne running from the back of the room, all the way to the front, yee. I was like, what the hell are you guys doing? That's how we call each other. It's like, oh, okay. So anyway, that was bad. That was one thing bad about my brother. He always used to wear my clothes. And I gave him dirty lickings for that. But he still took my clothes next month. Let's go back to the good. One thing good I remember about my brother, there were so many too. His family, he really loved his family. He always made time to go and support his family in any sports activities or family gatherings. And I never going forget that. How he always greet me when I show up to the parties. My brother, he hugs me tight and he asks me, "Hey bro, did you buy some more beer because you're running out?" I was like, "I just got here. How about you go get? I don't have money." He's like, "Here, take it and bring me the change back." He come back, he didn't give me back my change. But he really loved his family. He always catered to his family when in need. It never was an issue for him, even if he was going through his own problems. I was truly blessed with the real one, my brother. Wanna end this with a laugh from my bro? The most funniest thing I can remember with him. He got caught smoking cigarettes. He got caught smoking cigarettes from my pops. And he was in high school, maybe about 10th grade. My pops didn't want to lick him, so he made him light up on cigarette. He lighted up the cigarette, he smoked the whole cigarette. And the second time, light up the cigarette again, he smoked the whole cigarette again. Then the third one came, he said, he was about to cry. He said, "Papa, I cannot smoke this." "Why? You wanted to smoke?" "Smoke? I cannot. "Okay, get in your running position." And you know, knowing my brother, he was just so uncoordinated. He was non-sports, just like how his friend said, on the sidelines cheering. But so he's in running position and he was going and going, and then next thing you know, my pop said, "Left, right, left, right." And you know, when we grew up boxing and stuff, so my brother wasn't about that. So when he said left, right, meaning punch, left, right, left, right, he ended up going, "Oh." And you know, all of us were serious, like, because he's going to get lickings. But when he did that, we all started cracking up. We couldn't hold it in. My pops was just laughing to the top of his lungs. And he said, "Why you do that?" I said, "Left, right, left, right." "Oh, I didn't know, Pops. I'm sorry. Left, right, left, right." And he just threw his left, right. So anyway, that's one thing I remember about laughing with this guy, because he got away from dirty lickings from that day, because he made my pops laugh. But I want to say thank you to who came to show my brother love. I know he's smiling down up in heaven. Thank you all to who helped with getting all this together, my family and my friends. You know Bayne feels the love and appreciates it all. I love all of you. I want to say to Val, be strong and continue to get better. Thank you for all you have done for my brother. And I want you to know that we are family and we will always be here for you. We love you. Mama's boys, I love you guys for life. Since you guys was young, you guys was like my idols. You guys' harmonies was so clean. But growing up with you boys was a blessing, and thank you for sharing the memorable moments with me and my family, and especially Bayne. He loved you guys. Elijah, aka Johnny Sweet, thank you for taking my brother with you through your journey of music. That's what my brother always wanted. growing up, being on stage, singing his heart out. No shame in the game, man. You guys know him. Flat and all, still dancing. You guys know that too. Sometimes I tell him, you know, just keep it simple. If you keep it simple, you know, it pop up more. It'll shine more than just you messing it up or trying to do something special. But, yeah, thank you. Thank you, boys. My brother, Lo, my sister, Jada. I love you with all my heart. I'll always be here for you guys no matter what. I want you guys to be strong in these hard times and know that this is all God's plan. Bayne is saved and in peace with our Father God now. I love you guys. To my beautiful and amazing mother, my mom. Thank you for all you have done, Mom, for us. I don't know how you do it. With Pop's passing a couple months ago, and now your son. Watching you calling around and driving all around. Getting things together for Pop's and now being. Just holding up strong while I'm here beginning being a big crybaby. You are my hero, Ma. And I'm forever grateful for you. I wouldn't change anything growing up. I thank God for blessing me with a superwoman. Or should I say super mom? You are my mom and my forever. My brother, Bayne. You're gonna be missed, never forgotten. This is only temporary. And I know I'll be seeing you soon when the Lord says it's my time. Until then, bro, watch over us and give Pops a big hug for me. I love you, Bayne, Uipa, Tinei, Sua. Rest in love. Yee yee!
Thank you, William. We're going to have our first musical tribute, Mama's Boys, Johnny Sweet. If you gentlemen can please come on stage and do a song for Bayne. After that, of course, then we're going to start with this sharing of memories.
Testing, testing.
Someday I hope to see your face one day in that beautiful place. Beyond the clouds, beyond the stars, wanna be where you are, and I pray the Lord will keep you safe, and I pray there's a place with no worry, a place full of love. With familiar faces surrounding me, how I miss them so much. A place with no sorrow, a promise tomorrow, beyond what I can see, a place I long to be.
Yeah, 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 yeah. When I opened my eyes,
time I feel your touch,
let me
know that I could face tomorrow.
When all my friends, they go away, I'll be glad to stay. You're still living. Ooh, even when the wind blows by, I'll be warm inside. You're so lovely.
Every time I hear your voice,
every time I hear your voice,
every time I feel your touch,
every time
lets me know that I could face tomorrow one more time. My heart skip a beat, and the whole world stops, and I forget to breathe without your love.
Begin the sharing of memories, I'd like to call upon Bayne's brother Lauren.
Hello, everybody. My name is Lauren. I'm the second brother. I'm not good at this. So my brother Bayne was the one that loved to speak up. And my memory with him was thinking about my grandma's house in IL. Was up late. I think we was playing Tetris. And my brother came out sleepwalking. And my man just put on his pants. It's like, Bayne, what you doing? Oh, he quickly pulled his pants back up and said, oh, I'm just dancing. He started dancing. It's like, oh, why are you dancing? He's like, oh, don't you hear the music? My brother was just some clown. But that was like the... I don't know, that was like the first thing that popped in my head when I got the news. I was like, man, I just... Just thinking about a lot of stuff about him. And another one I wanted to share was... back at Cuckoo House. This is when my pops was giving us dirty lickings. And used to get that 2x4, and after the dirty lickings was over, I remember going in the room. I'm just crying, and I look at Bayne, my brother. He had layers of Bebadees and just like padding. I was like, oh, I don't know. This guy, I never thought of that. But I was thinking if I get caught with that. It's like, oh, yeah. I got to say the best memory I remember when we get was getting forced to go sleep. And sometimes we couldn't go sleep. Me and my brother used to like just sing like oldies, like Stylistics and like any old songs that we know. And always trying to, you know, one up on each other, like, oh, I get one better one. And it's like, oh yeah, yeah, okay. And we used to do that like almost every time, every night. But I don't know. I had a lot of good memories of my brother, and definitely gonna miss him. But thank you, everybody, and love you guys.
Oh, it's too tall. Aloha, everyone. I'm Bayne's sister, Jordan. Mahalo for coming out, showing your love and support, celebrating the life of my brother, Bayne. Oh, still high. Jeez. I can go on for days with stories talking about Bayne. Most of us knew him as the one always joking and laughing no matter what. He always put others first, even when he needed it the most. As you probably heard from most of us, he always made time for the people he loved, even if it made him late for work and music gigs, so on and so forth. He always made time and went out his way for family, always apologized and believed whatever hurt him, he deserved it. He was such a character and so extra in everything he did. He could reenact many movies and songs. He would sing and dance like it was a theatrical play. His favorites were the oldies but goodies, but then one time I remember I couldn't understand the song, The Children's Story by Slick Rick, until he said, "Watch me." Those who knew Bayne in school knew him as a guy who's always singing out loud and hitting high notes. I even used to have people I knew and didn't know around the city I grew up telling me, "He's so good." And sorry, bro, Will, but they even said better than you. And that he should be in Rebel Soldiers too. But he never saw that, even until recently. He looked up to my two older bros the most, trying to be like them and more. He didn't see he was already special and had his own personality that me and my brothers, our other brothers, could never compare to because we were too serious most times. Bayne was the clown out of us four. Seeing him first dance full-blown on stage made me so happy, but he was so embarrassed after just like every other gig, not really realizing that the crowd and everyone who saw the video loved it even until now. He was a great entertainer. He never gave himself credit, yet he was so smart, talented, humorous, and outgoing. Growing up, I was such a follower to my bros, and Bayne was a follower to our brothers Will and Lo. Will with his singing and Lo with his chill personality. But Bayne didn't see that he was just full of life. Anyways, back to me being a follower. Instead of Bayne doing things himself, he He would drag me into it too, so we both would get in trouble. Many of you probably know this funny story, but it would be stuff like when he was teaching me how to cook salmon in the microwave. I was like 6. He said we had to massage it every minute while it's hot. So there was me while burning my hands because he did it first. And all I remember was this is nasty and too much work, but I believed him. And I can't recall how long I did that for. It's like, even though you know it doesn't make sense, he just had that spirit that was hard not to believe and follow him all the time. One time we were about to get lickings. He copied our older brother Will by putting extra pants on. Instead of just one, he put on so much that he got caught and it was all over for all us siblings and cousins forever. Reason I brought that up is because there's so many memories you just can't forget with him, even if you tried. It was never a dull moment when it came to Bayne. My brother was so extra in everything he did in general, which is why people love him. And as people would say, he made it easy to love him. As much as I pissed Bayne off, he mainly would walk away and of course tease me later about it. He would also teach me songs he learned from chorus or from people and monitor me as if he was my singing coach. No matter how terrible I sang, even as an adult, he always encouraged me and never made fun of me. But Slick can see him silently giggling, even though his laughs were never soft. Everyone knows he has a powerful voice. And when we were kids, he would yell, "Sing louder, louder than me," and the radio, while I'm dying out of breath. He always saw two sides to a story, always heard me out. He always tried to make peace with me and anyone I fought or argue with, even with our older brothers. Anytime I was MIA, Bayne always made sure to keep me updated with the tea. My best memories with Bayne was playing all kinds of games even in high school, such as Pogs, video games, board games, and card games. Just us bonding in general. Other stuff like watching anime on school nights or getting up early to watch and record music videos on the VCR. Hanging out, working, or singing with friends. Being able to ugly laugh out loud because his was even louder. No one would notice mine. Full on singing and dancing with my mom and brothers in the car all the time, all kinds of music most times. I would just sit there and be embarrassed. And now I don't even care and wish I could always go back to those times. Other great memories I have with him would be how all of us four would play Rock Band, the game with the instruments, as if we were a real band group. Me and my brothers blasting music all day, every day for the whole building to hear, and some songs on repeat, just in the zone, singing out loud. And lastly, even though I was far away, he always made time to call me and answer my drunk calls. Then laugh about it when I'm sober, then call me when he's drunk talking about, "Now you have to listen to me." Sorry, I thought I was gonna keep this short, but everything just feels so weird now that there's just us three and not seeing all of us grow old together with our own families. I didn't realize he saw us being so close until Val brought it up. We were always together, and now I can never continue to build that with him. It hurts when you see that someone you love, time has come to an end, and you have to keep going. However, I am happy he is at peace in a better place with our pops, who he definitely tried to follow in his footsteps when it came to family and music. I will continue to live life for my brother Bayne, and hope everyone will as well, and pass down the love he gave to others. We live in a cruel world, and this world didn't deserve him. I love you, Laku.
Hi, everyone. My name is Val. This is very difficult for me to speak. This was hard for me to write this speech for my love. Bayne is my better half, my rock. My soulmate, my best friend, is my first love and my everything. We both met while working security 6 years ago, and I had an immediate crush on him. I fell in love with his outgoing personality, and of course, his amazing voice. I believe we clicked because we were so opposite of each other. He loved to sing, and I couldn't, but I loved his singing. He loved to play video games because he was good at it, and I sucked at it. He would laugh every time he would beat me. I would be so mad. I was such a sore loser. He could socialize with anyone and everyone. And me, not so much. But even though he loved to do things that I didn't really like doing, he would try his best to teach me how to sing. He'd try his best to teach me how to play games. And he would encourage me to talk to a whole bunch of people like how he would, especially at his gigs. I mean, he can volley out for days. He was loved for so many reasons. One reason was for his serving heart. He did a lot for many people, especially for our families. Family was everything to him. Whether we had a birthday party or a family event, he was right there, helping to set up or break down. He called himself the one-man cleaning crew, helping out with barbecuing, or he was the one scheduled to sing at the event. And it didn't matter if he just got off of working an overnight shift, he was there. Bayne was such a gentleman. He would always hold whatever I had in my hand, whether it was my bag or wallet. He would never let me carry it. He would open car doors, actually any door. He wouldn't let me open it. He had to open it. He did that from the start. From the beginning, and he never stopped being a gentleman. He wasn't only respectful to me, but I witnessed how respectful he was to the women in our family. He would do the same thing for them. He would always make an effort to find time for us to take our parents out to dinner and a movie. I loved those double dates. Even though it was okay that he snored so loud sometimes during the movie, because what counted most was us being together and bonding. I'm gonna miss going to his gigs and watching him sing his heart out. I could just sit there and just video him. I have many, many videos in my gallery, in my phone, that I just don't have the strength to open yet, till this day. I literally videoed him every chance I had. Of course, there are lots of others admiring his voice and his notes that he would be hitting. Lots of people admiring him, which I'm not gonna lie, made me a little jealous. Just a little bit though. But he'd always introduce me to everybody there. Always did. On his breaks, he would always make sure I ate or drank something. What most people were shocked about was the fact that he knew a lot of music from back then, and he would always tell them he learned it from his pops. These past few gigs, I comforted him because he would hide his tears after singing songs that reminded him of pops. He loved him so much and always shared memories of him. We were so sad when pops left. But now that they're both reunited in heaven, I know how happy he is. And I know they're up there singing. I'm going to miss our trips around the island. We'd make sure to stop and visit Pops. Send him our love. I'm going to miss him singing to me at any time and anywhere. He always sang everywhere. Our first concert was the Alan Stone concert. He also took me to meet Fiji. I didn't get to see him back him up, but he also took me to a few recording studios. I'll miss watching him sing with Elijah and Hannah. I'll miss him calling everyone to sing happy birthday to them when it was their birthday. I'll miss him answering the phone with yee-yee when it was his best friend's calling. And that was every day. I'm gonna miss his jokes and especially his laugh. I knew he loved me because he dealt with my loud and ugly laugh. I'll miss him picking me up from work, even when he forgot to. I'll miss him driving all the time, even if he didn't want to. Then when I drive, it's like he's still driving. I can just hear him. I'll miss yelling out, Kalihi, and then him throwing up the 94. I'll miss him yelling on the game with his friends, Bills, Scotty, Dusty, Connor. I'll miss cheering on the Eagles with him. I never knew the Eagles before I met him. I still remember when they won the Super Bowl against Tom Brady a few years back. We're the only ones going for the Eagles. Then I had to go back to cheering for the Packers. I miss us sharing clothes because we both wear t-shirts and basketball shorts. I miss him asking where my shades were because he always wanted to wear it. I miss watching him pluck his eyebrows because I sure didn't know how. He was my favorite mahu. It hurt so bad knowing I needed to live life for the both of us by myself. But I know I'm not alone. I know he's with me wherever I go. I know he knew how bad I wanted to be with him when he left, but he helped save me. The Lord said it wasn't my timing yet. The recovery process is so difficult because Bayne was always my strength. After hospital visits and surgeries, Bayne was always there helping me. Encouraging me, making sure I take my pills on time, eating the right foods, making sure I always drank water. Last year, he saved me from drowning at Waimea. He wasn't even in the water with me. He was watching me from the sand, and he ran so fast to pull me in. His nephew was like, Uncle, that's the fastest I've ever seen you run. A few years before that, he stood in front of me when we were both held at gunpoint from someone trying to rob us with a shotgun in a parking lot. He was my best friend. In every situation, we had each other's backs because our love for each other was so strong. We've been through so much, but there is no question about his love. He has such a big heart. I'll miss everything about him. But I'll miss his love the most. He never showed his pain. He always told me not to cry. He hated to see me cry. He said, you only cry when you're bleeding or dying. He never let me go through it. He never let me understand what he was going through. That was just the type of person he was. I have to learn to accept that. But I'll always have him with me in my heart, forever and always. Love you, honey. Always and forever. Wait for me. Thank you.
this time, I'd like to call upon the next performer, Rebel Soldiers, who's going to do the final musical tribute. Listening to the stories, I get jealous as a funeral director. I don't have the opportunity to know most of the loved ones that are in my care. And I get jealous when I listen to these stories because Bayne must have been an amazing person. And I would have loved to have had the opportunity to have known him. So let's continue to support the family, to support Val. Remember to call upon them, visit them, see how they're doing, especially during the holidays, the birthdays, the anniversaries, the times when they're going to miss Bayne the most. At this time, we'll have Rebel Soldiers.
Yeah, check, hey. So before we start this song, I just want to say my brother was a big song critic. He was my biggest critic, I'm not gonna lie. Every song that we released, he's always there waiting for me saying, "Hey bro, what is this about? What is this song?" You know what I mean? But anyway, this song was, he said this song was his favorite, and he helped me with this melody that I use now every time. So my brother, I love you. This is dedicated to you. My rebels, I love you guys. Thank you.
Life is on a spaceship. Don't know where it's heading. Miss our conversation. The way you used to love me. Oh, you know, back on
we had a good time.
White wine
dancing underneath the starlight, just you and I.
You kissed me upon my lips
the first time.
I can
tell a lie.
Yeah, baby.
But I'd sacrifice my days for one day with you.
One thing's for sure, even when the rain is falling, you know me in the middle of the storm. Somewhere out there in the flood, know that I'm there, no umbrella.
Cause the rain ain't
always bad.
Through this rain
our seeds can grow.
I hope you
think of home. I'd never leave you lonely.
I'm wishing on a spaceship.
Tears don't drown you, babe.
No, I know my destination. Is nowhere near you, it's killing me for sure. You know, back on Earth, we made some good plans to
romance,
making sweet love.
Slow jam, no hesitance. I give you all of me, baby.
And you gave me all of you,
your body, mind, and soul.
I always knew that we
would be inseparable.
Maybe you're not.
The time has changed,
but this heart's still
the same, yeah.
One thing's for sure,
even when the rain is falling, you know me in the middle of the storm. Somewhere out there in the flood, you know that I'm there, no umbrella. Always bad.
Through the rain our
seeds can grow.
I hope you
think of home. I'll never leave you lonely.
Through space and time, you'll always be mine. And nothing in this galaxy can keep me from your land. We left this world behind us the day we fell in love.
So even if it all falls down, loving you's enough.
We had a good time, dancing underneath the starlight, just you and I.
You kissed me on my lips
the first time. Tell a lie,
but I'd sacrifice
my days for one day with you. One thing's for sure, even when the rain is falling, you know me in the middle of the storm. Somewhere out there in the flood, you know that I'm there, no umbrella.
Cause this rain ain't
always bad.
Through this rain our seeds can grow. I hope you think of home.
I love it, babe.
I never leave you lonely.
Love you, Bayne.
Love you, B.
At this time, I'd like to call upon Pastor Bob. He's going to have the spiritual message and, of course, offer us some hope.
Good afternoon. My name is Pastor Bob. I'm one of the pastors here at Calvary Chapel Pearl Harbor. You know, it's amazing listening to all the testimonies that have come up here and shared about Bayne's life. And I never had the privilege or the opportunity to meet him, but all the things that have been shared about him makes me feel within my heart that I knew him. And let me tell you the reason why. Because the stuff that has been shared about Bayne, his willing to help, the sacrificial love that he showed to family, friends, and maybe even people that he didn't know. The fact that he has such a love and a passion for life lets me know that he had the qualities and characteristics of somebody that's very dear to my heart, and that is a person called Jesus Christ. He had those qualities within him, which is really, really wonderful of this young man. Second, listening to all the music here that has been expressed on this stage to reflect the type of person that he had a passion for, which was the entertainment industry. If there's one thing about music, if you don't know, whether you are a believer or not, it's the one balm that can really soothe and calm the heart in a time of a situation like this, when you are hurting, when you are going through tough stuff, difficult things. There's nothing like music that can bring a soothingness to you, to lift your spirits, to bring you to a place of appreciation. And this service is a celebration of Bayne's life. Yes, we are sad. You that knew Bayne well, those of you maybe didn't know him that well, but you were familiar with him in the industry and entertainment industry, it's a loss. I will say that. It's a loss. But this is not a time that we're going to talk about that aspect of Bayne. It's a time to celebrate his love and his life. And everything that has been shared up here today, up to this point, it lets me know the great appreciation that those of you that knew him had of Bayne. He impacted many of you in such a really special and a unique way. And that's what this is all about. Now, the way Bayne left this life is not an easy one to address. I will say that up front, because it can leave open and unanswered questions. But I'm going to share with some things I pray will shed some light, clarity, and truth on this matter. First of all, the one emotion that a person goes through that we all can struggle with, especially when you lose a loved one, somebody that's so dear and special to you, is the emotion of grief. And let me tell you why. Because why grief is such a difficult emotion to deal with is because grief has no expiration date. Think about it. What do I mean by that? Grief can show up at any time. It can show up at special occasions. It can show up at birthdays. It can show up at holidays, anniversaries. special events, even in the normal activities of life, grief can show up. And that's why it's very hard to deal and handle in those moments when it does happen. But on the flip side of grief, let me share something that is much different, and it's called hope. It's called hope. And hope also has no expiration date as well. Let me share with you what Paul the Apostle said in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13. And he said this, "But I do not want you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning those who have fallen asleep or have left this life, lest you sorrow as others who have no hope." And that's the point that I want to express here. Because as he goes on, Paul says, "For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so God will bring with him those who sleep in Jesus." Meaning, this life is temporary. Once this life is done, it's done. So what Paul is saying here, as Christians, we don't sorrow as if we don't have any hope. Paul simply is saying that our hope is not found in a religion. It's not in the here and now, this life that we are presently living in, but in the life to come. And that's why a Christian does not sorrow as a person who has no hope, because hope is only found in a relationship with Jesus Christ. Why? Because Jesus is the only one that can guarantee eternal life. Eternal life. If that wasn't true, then I would be a fool to walk with Christ, give my life to Jesus Christ. It's now been 43 years. How do I know that? Because he's changed me. Now, some of you might remember, I was here a couple of months ago for Pop's funeral. They were giving me the privilege to do his service. And this is not easy. This is hard for me as well. Even though I did not know the family, did not know Pops or Bayne, it's never easy to do something like this. Why? Because as a human being, I have compassion for life. I know what it's like to lose loved ones. I lost my wife, 32 years old. She died in 1986. It's not easy when you lose somebody special to you. Does the grief come back from time to time? Certainly, because grief has no expiration date. On special moments, occasions, it'll just hit me like that. It'll bring me to tears. But I have to move on with my life, because that's what God's called me to do. And like Bayne, every one of us here, we struggle in life. There's struggles in life that we face. Jesus, and especially now, you know what I'm talking about. This situation we've been dealing with for the past 2 years has changed the perspective on how we handle things. You know, financial and economic challenges we've all been hit with. Having to live together that we're not used to for extended period of time tests our patience, our resilience, and our fortitude as a family and as loved ones. And we all know the situation. It causes a lot of stress upon all of us here. Jesus himself said that not everything in this life would go well, not the way we planned. He himself said in John chapter 16, verse 32, "These things I have spoken to you, that in me you might have peace, but in the world you shall have or will have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. I have overcome the world." But here's the beautiful thing. Let me share this. I'm going to bring clarity about the situation with Bayne. Here's the beautiful thing about Bayne concerning all that has happened. He has been justified before God. Understand that. Romans chapter 5, verse 1 says this, "Therefore, having been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ." When I talked with Sophia and sister, they had told me that Bayne had a strong belief in God. And because he trusted in Jesus and all that Jesus has done for him, check this out. Jesus finished the work for his redemption. Jesus paid the ransom for Bayne's sin. And Jesus satisfied the justice that God required for Bayne's guilt, you see. In other words, Jesus did it all for him. He did it all for him. That's the beautiful thing. Why we can sit here today and celebrate Bayne's life. Irregardless of how it happened, that's irrelevant. It's what God does in the here and now. Because here's this. One dark moment in a Christian's life, in Bayne's life, cannot undo what Jesus did for us, did for Bayne on the cross, because God's grace is greater than any sin you see. Any sin you see. Because, hear this. When you stand before God, when I stand before God, when Bayne stood before God, he is not going to judge us by the last thing we did before we die. Listen carefully. But by the last thing Jesus did when he died. When he died. And what was the last thing Jesus did when he died? There are two. There are two things. One, while he's on the cross, he said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they do." What is that? It's an expression of love. And all the things that Christ was going through at that moment on the cross, he had within him the strength to say, "Father, forgive them. They don't know what they're doing." That's an expression of love. Romans chapter 8, verses 35, verses 37, 39. Listen to what it says. Can anything ever separate us from Christ's love? Does it mean he no longer loves us if we have trouble or calamity or are persecuted or are hungry or cold or in danger or threatened with death? No. Despite all these things, overwhelming victory is ours through Christ who loved us. And I'm convinced that nothing can ever separate us from his love. Death can't, life can't. Our fears for today, our worries about tomorrow, and even the powers of hell can't keep God's love away. Whether we are high above the sky or in the deepest ocean, nothing in all creation will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed in Christ Jesus our Lord. Nothing can separate us from the love of God. Listen to this. Nothing could ever separate Bayne from God's love. And that's a wonderful truth and something that you can grab on, because regardless of what was going on in Bayne's life, God will never cast him aside because of what Jesus did upon the cross for all of us, you see. Second thing that Jesus did when he died is his resurrection. He rose from the dead, because without the resurrection, there is no salvation. There is no eternal life. That is why the resurrection of Christ is important. Not that he was the Son of God, that Jesus Christ is God. When he said, I and the Father are one, he was talking about the unity that he had with God the Father here upon this earth. And that's what makes the resurrection relevant, you see. Now I'm going to share with you a story that's found in John chapter 11. Maybe some of you know it. It's about Martha, Mary, and their brother Lazarus. I'm going to paraphrase the story for time's sake. Lazarus was sick, so the two sisters sent word to tell Jesus, hey, our brother's sick. Can you come and check it out and help us out here, heal him? And then Jesus says something very interesting. He told the people that came, tell the sisters that, hey, listen, Lazarus' sickness is not unto death, but unto the glory of God, and that through the work that Jesus would do, the Son of Man would be glorified in this matter. So on purpose, Christ waited 2 days before he went to Bethany. On purpose. For what reason? So that Lazarus would die. So as he entered the city, Martha came to him and said, hey, if you would have been here earlier, Christ, my brother wouldn't have died. But I know that whatever you ask of God, he will give it to you to do. And then Jesus says something very interesting to Mary. She said, Martha, your brother will rise again. Martha goes, well, I know he will rise again in the last time. And he replies back, he will rise again in the resurrection of the last day. And then Jesus did this. He said to Mary, then asked her a question in John chapter 11, verses 25 and 26. He said this, Mary, Martha, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he may die, yet he shall live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Then he turned to Martha and said, Martha, do you believe this? Do you believe this? And the reply of Martha in verse 27 was this. She said to him, yes, Lord, I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, who came into the world, confessing who Jesus was. So let me ask all of us here this afternoon the same question. Do you believe this as you sit here? We've been here celebrating and reflecting on the life of Bayne. But Bayne is not here. We are still here. And that question that Jesus asked Martha, the same question he asked every one of us here today, do you believe this? Because if you believe in Jesus Christ and you commit your life to him, the Bible says you'll have eternal life. Romans 10, 9 and 10. If you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you shall be saved. And then in verse 10, he says, with the heart one believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth one believes unto salvation. And verse 13, for anyone who calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. You see, shall be saved. Listen, when something like this happens, the question I'm sure every one of you had said, why? I don't know. I don't know why this happened. I don't know why God didn't prevent it. I don't know why God didn't intervene. I don't. I wish I could give you the answers to that question, the whys of God. It's a mystery that is not shared with us within the Bible, why things happen to us. But better than ask this, the question why, is who do we turn to in a time like this? That question I can answer for you. In a time like this, you turn to Jesus Christ. That's who you turn to. In Hebrews 13, verse 5, Jesus himself says, I will never leave you and I'll never forsake you. Listen, God was with Bayne. Let me tell you this, my friends. God was with Bayne all the way to the end. Why? Because God promised it. God will never go back on what he says he will do. He was with Bayne all the way to the end, you see, which is beautiful. I wish I knew this guy. He would have been fun to be around. He would have been a fun person to be around. Hear the stories of the brothers' testimonies of, you know, the trouble they got into. We all do that as kids. I can remember getting in trouble with my brothers, and not with my brothers, not myself. But the point is, what I like that's been expressed here by family is the unity and the togetherness and the importance of being together and spending time with those whom you know. It's very important. Because family outside of God is the most important core you have in life. Without family, you don't have anything. And I share this often. Make sure you have a tight and good bond and interaction with your family. I don't care what problems you have. I don't care what issues you have, things you've gone through. Make it right. You don't want to leave this earth and never resolve indifferences with a family person, whether mom, dad, brother, sister, auntie, uncle, grandma, grandpa. Make it right. They're dear to you. Obviously, talking to Sophia and the family, he was so connected to Pops. He loved his Pops. My dad's parents, I love my parents, them to death. You know why? Because they were the first generation Christians in all the Fukui family tree, and they prayed for me for 10 years to get saved. And their prayers came to pass. And the first person I called to when I gave my life to Christ was my grandma. And she stayed faithful all the way to the end. And I have a lot to owe to her because she never gave up on me. That's why it's important with family. And it's so neat to hear the interaction, the connection, the love, the deep love that Bayne had for Pops. That is so special. Nobody can take that away. And like has been shared, man, he's up there having a blast with Pops. All those that he knew that left this earth before him, he's having a blast with. So in closing, what happened to Bayne, let me share this. What happened to Bayne doesn't get the last word. Hope gets the last word. Jesus gets the last word. Why? Because Jesus is hope. But not only that, sorrow will not have the final say, because in heaven, God will replace sorrow with everlasting joy and happiness. Everlasting joy and happiness. Listen to what Revelation chapter 21, verse 4 says. And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. But here's what's interesting. Even though God will wipe away every tears, let me share this. Every tear that Sophia, the brothers, the sister has shed for Bayne, God says he captures those tears in his bottle of remembrance. He remembers every tear that we shed for somebody that's dear to us. Because God is a God of emotion. God is a God of compassion. He remembers. That to me is quite interesting, that the psalmist would declare to us that every tear we shed, God remembers. He puts it in his bottle and he remembers them. That shows you how detailed God is with the emotions that we go through as people living here on this earth. He knows what we suffer. He knows our hearts. He knows what we go through. And that's what makes our God that we serve, the God that we know, so wonderful. But listen to what it says. God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There shall be no more death, nor sorrow, nor crying. There shall be no more pain, for the former things have passed away. You come into a new life. But listen, one final scripture I want to share with you is in Isaiah chapter 51, verse 11. And I read this, and talking with the family and hearing everything that's been going on, the testimonies, this reminds me of Bayne. Listen what it says. So the ransom of the Lord shall return and come to Zion with singing, with everlasting joy on their heads. They shall obtain joy and gladness. Sorrow and sighing shall flee away. You know, Bayne's taken all that talent that God has given him as an entertainer, and guess what he's doing right now? He's entertaining in heaven with worship. With worship. He's singing his little heart out to those that are part of the heavenly choir. And I can imagine the beautiful music that he's doing right now. But the question we all need to ask ourselves is, where will we be when the journey in this life for us comes to an end? That's what's important. Life is short. If you think about it, you live to be 50, 70, even 100 years, which is a long, fruitful, prosperous life. But what does that compare to eternity? What's this, the definition of eternity? There is none. It goes on and on and on and on. And Bayne's there right now. It's going on and on and on for him. And I'm sure that's something that he would want you to also, as part of his circle, to join him in eternity one day. So with that, will you bow your heads with me? Oh, and one last final thing. That brother that came up here and shared about the football stuff, I was pretty funny, and August Aarons, you know, he went to August Aarons Elementary School. Hey, God bless you, bro. My wife's a teacher there, so that's awesome to hear that. But he shared one thing, and I wrote it down, and I want to remember. He said, we all need to be ready. We all need to be ready. I thought that was so wonderful. The last thing he left was, you know what? Let's be ready, because we never know when we will take our last breath on earth. Let's pray. Will you bow with me, please? Father, we thank you this day as we celebrate the wonderful life of this young man, Bayne Sua. He impacted a lot of lives. He touched a lot of hearts. He was such a giving, loving, a selfless, sacrificial person. He had all the characteristics, all the attributes that we see in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And yes, God, he will be missed, but we pray the legacy he left behind will impact others to follow and to go on to do better in their own life as well. But as we're praying, if you're here and you're trying to understand what is all of this about, eternal life, salvation, relationship with Christ, it's just giving your heart to him. So the Bible says when you do that, God will take your name and write it in what is called his book of life, meaning that when you stand before the heavenly gates, he can open the book, your name is there, and he'll welcome you in. So if you're here this day and you don't know Jesus, we always do this. We always want to give an opportunity. You want to give your life to Jesus. You say, yeah, I don't want to live this life. It's tough. It's very difficult, full of challenges. Well, Jesus is there to help you. He says, come to me, all you labor and heavy laden, I will give you rest. If you want rest today, he provides that rest for you. So with everybody praying, if that's something you want to do, then I'm going to ask you to do one thing. Just raise your hand. Acknowledge, I want Jesus in my life before I leave this place today. Anybody here, we always give that opportunity. Father, you know every heart that is here. We ask and pray that you use them, you comfort them in this time of loss and sorrow and grief. And I pray for the Sua family, Lord. May they feel your presence through this time. May you provide for every need they have. We do thank you for this service. We ask now, and all that's been shared and said and shared, you're glorified, this family is blessed, and everybody leaves this place in a better condition than when they came in. As we pray this in Jesus' name, amen. God bless you, and thank you. Anyway, if you need a Bible, we have Bibles in the back. They're free. You can come pick one up. And just see any of the guys in the back, Pastor Chris, Pastor John, is that Ben? Ben, yeah, they'll be more than happy to give you a Bible. God bless you.
Before we conclude the services, we're going to have a memorial slideshow. And after that, we're going to have the closing prayer by Scotty.
Yeah, but there is no sunshine. And nothing but clouds, and it's dark in my heart, and it feels like a cold night.
Today's a new day, yeah. But where are my blue skies? Yeah. Where is the love and the joy that you promised me? Tell me it's alright.
I almost gave up, but a power back I can't explain. From heaven like a shower. Say I smile, even though it hurts. Say I smile, yeah, yeah. I know God is working, so I smile. Even though I've been here for a while, I smile.
Ooh, smile.
It's so hard to look up when you've been down. I
sure hate to see you give up now. So much better when you smile. So smile.
Don't forget who you are. Don't forget who you are. Go.
Today's a new day. But there is no sunshine. Nothing but clouds, and it's dark in my heart, and it feels like a cold night.
Today is a new day. Yeah.
Tell me where I'm. Joy that you promised me, tell me it's alright.
Come on. I almost gave up, but a power that I can't explain.
Sorry, it's been a while since I prayed. Father God, thank you so much for everything you've done for us. We gather here not to say goodbye, but to see you soon, see you again. Father God, thank you for sharing the greatest memories with Bayne. The love that you've given us through him. Father God, I pray that whatever he's been through or whatever he's going through, I pray that you share his talent in the next life. Share his love that he has given us. Father God, I pray that you watch over any of us that's going through, that he's been going through. Give us the strength that you have given anyone that could be at. Father God, I thank you. We all thank you for everything you've done for us. I pray that everyone becomes strong with whatever pain they go through. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the celebration of life for Bayne. Once again, on behalf of the entire family, they do wish to express their appreciation to all of you for being here. We only have about 15 minutes, and that will be reserved only for the immediate family so that they can spend some time with Bayne before we depart for the cemetery. For those of you that will be joining us at Valley of the Temples, please remember to take a bento before you leave. Burial is scheduled for 3 o'clock this afternoon. At the conclusion of those services, the family invites you to their residence at 94535 Avamoy Street in Waipahu, where the celebration will continue, where they'll have kanikapila and just to balaao, share talk story and to be with one another. And as you leave the church this afternoon, do drive home safely and mahalo for being here.